Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I missed a week of filming and I'm so sorry. I thought I'd actually be with it and like filming one every single week, but I kind of just didn't really know what to film. Plus I was super busy last week between prep and work and everything. So today, because I have a little bit of spare time because a few of my sessions have been moved and canceled, I'm gonna film one of my shoulder sessions for you guys today. And also just like a little bit of a day in the life. Stuart's here with me as well, so maybe we'll get around to some of those questions you guys asked as well. Wow, my eyebrows are like doing something weird. But anyway, so this is just a shoulder session. I hope you guys like it. Don't remember, ladies, to always train your upper body. If you want to create that hourglass figure, you need to make sure you're always in proportion. So even if you just grab some light weights and give this one a turn. So let me know what you think. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know what else you want to see. See you at the gym. Bye. Exercise number one. Holding for two. And slow for three, or in Stuart's case, go really fast because he's not listening to me. Beautiful.
Babe, you make a sound. 2 a.m. love, gotta keep it down. Don't wait around while sitting down.
Okay, so what we're doing, guys, is we're doing 10 reps, 5 exercises with 5 sets. We have a 2 second static hold, and then a 3 second eccentric phase with all the exercises that we're doing today. And we're also building up our weight with each set. So as soon as you can't hit 10, that's probably our max weight for that exercise. So we're just slowly building up for each of our reps. As you can see, it starts to get really hard and you start to take heaps, especially with that eccentric phase and that static hold. So I put on my Instagram the other day talking about traps, and now for those who don't know, those are what a trap is. Mine are obviously all pumped up now because when I train shoulders or anything upper body, my traps like to take over. Throughout this video, I'll show you guys just some techniques that I've learnt to try and not make your traps work as much when you're doing your shoulder exercises. But honestly, it is just like that mind to muscle connection, so you really need to think about not using them. So just then when Stuart was watching me do my exercise, he was making sure to put his fingers on there so I could mentally connect, put them down, and try not to use them as much. Anytime I do anything the delt wise or anything fly wise, I always just use my traps, and I really just need that someone to just yell at me to stop doing it, because they just take over and it's so frustrating, and then that just goes all up into my neck. But I will eventually learn. Hold one, two, or not. One, two, three, hold one, two, press. Awesome. So with these guys as well, you're definitely going to drop your weight because of that static hold and that eccentric phase instead of just pumping out the reps. Grr, look at my shoulders. Me. Okay, so I need a squat. Okay guys, so we're gonna go into side raises. So it's these ones with both hands with the dumbbells. Now this one is the one I find goes really a lot into my traps. Now my coach taught me like a little trick, makes it a lot better, is pull back, pull down. So really keep those shoulders in the sockets. And when we pull up, it's like you're pouring a glass. See how my side goes a lot more defined compared to when I go like this? So from here, I just go that whole way up. I don't go the full way up like I would here, because that's where I go trap. But because I've put down, I'm really activating that muscle and really getting it to work, and I can't actually use my traps. It's as soon as I go like this, my traps engage. So if you're finding that you're getting a lot of trap tension when doing these side raises, think back, down, and watering can, or pinkies up because you're fancy. Try that out and hopefully you won't annoy your traps as much. Okay, so you'll start with the dumbbells behind, slight bend the elbows, shoulders back, down, fourth, deep. similar to your side raises, you want to think back and down for our upright rows, leading with your elbows so that you can protect your wrist. Bring it to the top of your chin, pull, and slow down. Keep your core tight. And we're going to finish with calves, because I don't remember the last time I trained calves.
Neither.
And I have baby calves. Like, that's just skin. It's just a lot of skin. So we're going to do, you reckon, like 3 sets of 20? Just calf raises to finish that shorter session. Just letting everyone know, this is my least favorite thing in the whole entire world.
You didn't even own calves.
I'm not gonna enjoy any of this. Oh my god, this isn't easy. I don't have carbs. I don't remember the last time I trained carbs. I'm not even joking. Oh, this is painful. Okay, I'm just doing 15. I hated every second of that. You know what's so bad? I'm gonna do 3 sets of 15 and I bet you I won't be able to walk tomorrow just because I never trained them. I feel like I could just like contour them on maybe. Everyone's gonna have these like amazing calves at comp and I think I'm gonna have to like put bronzer on them or something just so that there's like a line while I wear my heels. Ugh. Hey guys, we just got back from the gym and we're both just having protein oats. Mine's just oats and chocolate brownie bowls protein, and Stuart's got vanilla ice cream protein and Nutella in his. So I asked you guys a couple of days ago about some questions to ask both of us, and I kind of just wanted them to be like entertaining, not really about fitness, so that like people who don't really care about fitness can like have a lol. The first one is, I guess, for Stuart from Julia. Who's your favourite brother?
Angus. He's not as grumpy.
And I only have one brother, so I guess it's just Cade. If you were an animal, what animal would you be?
Is this for me or you?
Both, but you can go first.
I'm a butterfly.
We did an animal personality test when we first started hanging out, and Stuart thought it'd be like this like intense, like ferocious animal, and it turns out he's a butterfly and I'm like a jaguar.
Jaguar or tiger.
Or a leopard, yeah. Or something. I think if you knew Stuart, like he's literally like a dog. Like a, what dog did I decide you were?
Golden retriever.
Like a golden retriever. Everyone thinks he's like a golden retriever because Zach's all tough, but then all he literally wants is like to hug and cuddle. No, you're being softy on the inside. Do you guys see yourself having kids? And if so, how many?
17 kids.
Fuck no. I wouldn't be able to bounce back. I don't know. I reckon like 2 or 3.
I want 2 kids.
I want 2 or 3. Depends. I want at least a girl. So hopefully I don't have to pop out 17 to at least have one of each. But I mean, I wouldn't care anywhere you go, but if I could pick, that's what I'd want, at least. So it's like a bit different. But we both have pretty, well, we don't really have big families, but we have siblings.
My family's pretty big.
Your family's pretty big. I just have my 2 siblings, and you have like 2 brothers and a sister. So like, I'd want like a few, because it's more fun.
Goodbye, Stu and iPhone. Thanks, Bonnie.
She really doesn't like your Samsung.
She doesn't.
How did we meet? Stuart, how did we meet?
Through friends. I tried to
get PG version.
Yeah.
My ages ago, like
a little while ago, I tried to
find her
to meet her. Yeah, but she blew me off. Which kind of sucked, but then about a year and a half later.
No, it was way longer than that.
Was it 2 years, maybe a year and a half, was it?
Oh, maybe actually, you might be right. Pretty much our 2 best friends at the time tried to get us together because they were dating. And then I just wasn't into it.
She didn't like me.
She had a party phase instead. And then, yeah, and then we just started hanging out again. And then...
She never left?
Then I guess.
I'm stuck with her now.
Yeah, and now we have a house together, so... Oh, apartment.
Yeah.
Good to have a job. And now he's about to leave me again, so... Do we have before photos or when we start working out?
I don't.
Do you do?
Oh, yeah.
You used to be pretty skinny. Still from all that party. Still from that from that party phase, he was pretty skinny. I'll see if I can find some. I'll make them like the cover photo of this something. Just a photo of you. They're pretty much all the funny ones.
Are you from the UK?
No. I wish. Nah. My whole family's from the UK. Don't. It's just my sister, my brother, and I that aren't. But so no. It's like you're not from the UK either. Your sister lives here though.
Mm-hmm.
What meals would you recommend for someone trying to gain weight? For girls and boys, it's pretty much the same. It's just the quantity of the food. If you're trying to gain weight, I'd 100% recommend weighing your stuff out. It's what we did with Stuart and he gained, like, how many kilos did you gain when we did that?
5 kilos.
Gained 5 kilos in what, like a month?
Yeah, about 6 weeks, 5-6 weeks.
And then you went to Splendor and lost it all.
Yeah.
But yeah, but you can do it, it's just you have to be accountable.
Just the right foods, the right proportions.
Yeah. Yeah, that's us. So, hope you found us interesting. I feel like there's nothing else really that interesting about us. He's gone to the Air Force. You should ask him about that. He loves to talk about it. I'm even the person that usually asks him about it. He leaves in, what, 2 weeks? 3 weeks.
3.5 weeks.
Yeah. So I'll probably be YouTubing a lot more because I'll be bored as hell. But that's okay. And I'm 7 weeks out of my comp, so stay tuned. I'm going to get shredded. Yeah, Stuart's had enough now, so I'll see you guys in my next YouTube video. And make sure you comment below. What else? Hey, you almost dropped the camera.
That's your fault.
Oh, I'll see you.